Hello everyone and welcome to the final set of us wrapping up this Let's Play. Now, last I mentioned that this set was going to be the final battle with Corypheus, I decided, hell with that. Instead, we'll be finishing up the last two side quests and the final dragon of this game. So, let's get to what they are. First and foremost, we have... What the fuck is that? Oh yeah! Oh really? Interesting. Okay, sorry. We're going to be doing the Cradle of Sylvan, and the Lost Temple of Dithramen. Now, I'm going to explain how you unlock these two, and then we'll get into them. First things first, we'll be going to the Temple of Sylvan. Sylvan is actually unlocked through a very interesting little area. First things first, if you want to get it, you have to go to the Empress du Lion. And then over in this section over here, on a little alcove, you'll find a tent with a corpse, a box, and a book. Read the book, and he'll mention where the Cradle of Sylvan is. Pretty easy to get to. Now, the fun thing about this is, if we're able to finish this quest, you get one of the strongest weapons in the game for a two-handed character. If you've actually seen my Mitsuki playthrough, it is the sword she is using, or at least the design of it. Because, with the Trespasser DLC... No. With the... what was it called? The Black Emporium, there we go. With the Black Emporium DLC, which is free, you can buy legendary schematics, one of which is the Blade of Sylvan schematic. It gives you the two-handed sword as a schematic, which you can make, and it's pretty fucking awesome. So, I recommend getting it. Anyway, let's get to it. Alright, our party is Cassandra, Dorian, and Cole. Let's go do it. I will explain how to get the Lost Temple of Dithramen after this. Now, if you're trying to grind for schematics, I'm going to say this real quickly. This is the perfect place to do it. I'll explain how this is done once we get inside. Now, I should not have been here before, so we should be good. There is no cutscene coming in, so we're fine.
So this is where the Sylvan Blade was lost. Lots of things are lost here.
This place is also filled with gold, too. But what is great about this place is that it's really small, and it has chests all over the place. So if you go to a chest like this, look through it, see what you want, take what you want, and then back out... That chest is still there. Still has stuff there. Now, if you fast travel to a different area, say back to Skyhold, the Emporium, or just to any of their places, and then fast travel back, this chest will be completely restocked with new gear. Now, if you go through everything and do a run through quickly and get all the chests, or check all the chests, you can find new schematics in all of them, sometimes. You're almost guaranteed to find a schematic each time, so keep that in mind. Yeah, pretty much. Alright, so we gotta find some Veilfire. So you'll see me do this while I'm running through here, just looking for stuff. Nope. I'm actually gonna ignore them because it's kind of boring watching me do that. Alright then. We should have a door over here. There it is. Ah! Give me that. I wonder. Nah. I'll drop my Veilfire. I don't want to do that. Not yet, anywho. Fine. Alright. Give me this back up. There we go. And in here, Mosaic Tablet, please. And a spirit rune. Now, all the runes that you get by this way, by the way, I keep forgetting to mention this, are dependent on the previous one you had. So if that was the first time I found a spirit rune, I would have just gotten a spirit rune, not the superb. So keep that in mind. I mean, this place is just filled to the brim with chests, in case you can't tell. Never clear it out unless it's only a schematic inside. Then, take everything you want. I actually spent quite a bit of time on Nexus, my original character, going through here and collecting as much as I could, which is why I have so much shit in my schematics. Revenant! Kill it! Kill the fire! And now you're dead. We'll pick this back up. Loot the corpse. And we get the Elfhand Sword Guard.
It's only part of the sword. The elves broke it after all. And no one's recovered it since, thanks to the Revenant. There must be more altars.
So basically, the backstory of these legendary Sylvan Blade is that the sword was very powerful, was crafted in a time of war for war purposes. And when the war ended, the blade was too powerful, so they decided to break it into pieces and then have the Revenants guard it, which is pretty much all we need to know to reforge it. Oh, that's right. This is one of those ones where I actually have to use my magic. I can't just use the freaking thing. The brazier.
The torch, not the brazier. That's something different. There it is. Lucky they have some pretty badass runes equipped, so this thing is just gonna go down.
The more pieces we have, by the way, the more corpses it summons to help. Which is why Cole died. I was able to fully upgrade my healing mist, so now I can resurrect people just by throwing the healing mist on them. Give me that.
I'm not certain I can explain it to you. You love him, but you're angry. They mix together, boiling in the belly until it kneads into a knot. Sometimes love isn't enough, Cole.
Aww. Poor Cole. He just doesn't understand. Boop. After all, he is a spirit. Technically, Cole isn't a he. Technically, he isn't a she. Cole's just a spirit. Compassion. And that's not gender required. So it's kind of interesting that type of philosophy, him trying to understand why that's a problem. This is my favorite one, right here. Like that, and boom. Nice. I found some pretty cool schematics here, so make sure to check this out. Pretty good. Alright, let's go ahead and get this piece. There's one left of this. Lay down the bombs! Alright, and now we have to take care of the piss ants. Boom, fuck you. Come on, die! And there he goes, last one. Fuck. Alright, let's loot the corpse as well. Got the sword's blade. Pick it up and keep it up. God damn. Bear in mind, by the way, if you come down here, this place is filled with eternally spawning corpses. So you'll keep fighting them. Of course, it's usually only like one at a time or something like that. I've never been able to fish them all up. Then again, I never really fought them all when I was grinding for schematics. Boop! Last one! Where is it? There it is. Oh, and you're a tough one, ain't ya? For some reason, I don't have it in the bottom right.
It didn't trigger out. Or trigger up. There it is. That was. And now it's dead. Last one.
which we'll do once we're done with the Lost Temple of Dithermin and the Dragon. I'll probably forget about it by then. Okay, to unlock the Lost Temple of Dithermin, this one requires going to the Exalted Plains. Throughout the Exalted Plains, specifically the southern portion of the map, there are elven ruins where you can find Veilfire and runes. There's one up over here, if memory serves. Yeah, right by here. One in here, which is about on this wall over here. One over here in the shrine to Celes. I think that's it. There's one more. In here in the forest. It's on the southern wall portion of it. It's near a broken bridge. Down, it has stairs going down. If you get all four of them, and you can talk to the keeper of the tribe over here, he'll tell you about it. You also get a you also have to go to the war table and unlock it with power. And they'll unlock the Lost Temple of Dithermin. Dithermin is a Dalish god of secrets. So, pretty cool. The only reason why I know that, by the way, is because my warden for my rogue, who was a Dalish elf, she had the Valisleen, which is the facial tattoos, of Dithermin. So it's pretty cool. I spent time going, okay. I know the character, I know the backstory, I know what I want. What's the proper Valisleen? Because the Valisleen is dependent on the which god that elf most identifies with, or prefer, or likes, or something like that. To the point they have a tattoo on their face that represents their devotion to that god, and shows their an adult. Alright, there it is. I knew it was around here somewhere. Boop. Ah, it's fire.
Strange that I can understand that. A spell of comprehension, perhaps. Amazing that it still functions.
Alright. We got a head. Eating the magic. Oh, hi. I was trying to see, but I couldn't really make them out. Luckily, these guys are pretty much piss ants. There we go.
It's a line. It's part of a ritual, I'd say. Whoever that belongs to, they're not dead. Not really.
Of course, well, there's no one in there. Oh well. Another one of those runes, I should say. Alright, let's go ahead and light these. There we go. Pull this lever so I can get in there without losing my Veilfire. Yeah, there was water running down the middle, in case you couldn't tell. Which makes it impossible to get this. There's another rune. Alright, let's kill these assets. Come on! That was easy enough. By the way, I find it funny that water can get rid of this thing, but if you drop it into the lake right here, or this little water area, it stays lit. It's like, Alright. Magic wall, get rid of it. Right. Come on. There we go. Another mosaic piece. The last one's in here somewhere. Freed our slaves. Oop, let's examine. They came for me in the night, but I won't let them take it. I'll find Dithermin's wisdom on my own. Those traitors want riches for themselves. They won't have a clue how to decipher the remainder of the ritual. Let be known that I, Lord Gareth Falks, am not to blame for what befalls them. I am not to blame for any of this. temple, a mural dedicated to Dithrumen. Let's light these. Like being able to see. Good place to get Rashvine by the looks of it. Alright, like that. This human man was a warrior, dead for perhaps a few months. His skin is dried and stretched over his bones. From what you can tell of the corpse, he was stabbed in the back. An expression of terror remains locked on the rictus of the man's face. In the rictus, rigor mortis. Good question. Alright, what's this? There it is, I knew it was around here somewhere. Light. Cool, be so kind. Thank you, buddy. Give me through, there we go. Before we go that way, another rune. Brings up brass 7. No more. Take the next piece. Boom. Fuck all of you. One of these guys has a key on them, by the way. Keep that in mind. Possessed Explorer. Ah, lovely. It's the one on the right. Well, it survived the longest. Ah, give me that. Not the one I was looking for. Then I guess ornate elven key.
This is key. One of the passages back in the ritual area, perhaps.
Yep. What's this? Oh, this! This is actually kind of cool. This is a lizard man. Or something along those lines. I can't remember. The scaled ones. There we go. They were a unknown race of beings that I believe hunted dwarves. Not much is known about them, really, but there are still very few depictions of them. They're basically similar to humanoid dragons, as far as we could tell, from what we've learned. Hard night down. Go Varric. But either way, it's pretty cool to look into. The biggest prevailing theory of what the scaled ones were people that were, God, what are they called? Reavers, who fell into the, kill you, who became cursed by their blood power and turned into like human dragon hybrids. If you remember, I think I remember mentioning this to them. Cassandra actually mentioned that her ancestors were Reavers, and legend says that it happened to them.
I can see them. You can see the whispers. Yes. All the way through this gate. Wonder what it's made of.
So yeah. Oh, that's right. It was in Mitski's playthrough because she's a Reaver. Mitski's a Reaver. She talked to Cassandra about it. And she mentioned that her ancestors were Reavers as well, but they became very hostile and basically grew scales and horns and became the little things would set them off. The biggest belief what the gray the scaled ones were that they were people who went under this transformation as Reavers. It's all pretty cool if you look into it. Path of Secrets. Run through that. There's a new somewhere. One more. Nope. I'm gonna try and keep my torch. I'm trying my best to go through this entire thing without losing this one torch. Why? Because I want to. Normally this would be a dead end, but I can actually jump over this shit. And ignite. Alright, next piece. Bring it, bitch! As a fair warning, by the way, I'm recording all these sets in advance. I plan my best to get this entire Let's Play done by the end of the day. That way my workload's a hell of a lot easier in the near future. I can also start pre-recording other Let's Plays once I get this done. And some of the things I have planned, whew, that would be helpful. Kill Sassat. Come on, die! Jeez! There we go! Gimme this. There we go. Alright, continue onwards. Jump! And just so you guys know, if you haven't seen my other Let's Plays, feel free to check them out, especially the Dragon Age ones. That way you get the whole picture of what the hell's going on. Where's Cole? There's Cole! I don't think I need to go in here. Go through! Cole, move your immovable body, goddamn! There we go. It's like, come on guys, move! And the last rune is up here. Somewhere. There it is. There it isn't. It's in here somewhere, I know that much. Ah, there it is. Last one. Jump. Woohoo! Alright, next area. Which is the final area. Let's go ahead and open this door. Alright. Boop! We have all the things we need. All we need to do is kill these guys so they don't follow us. And then go take care of whatever the hell's going on. Friendly advice, stave up your focus. You'll need it. Especially if I get an elite version of what's going to come. Whew, boy. Not looking forward to that. Alright, he's dead. Get the last one. Boom. Fuck you. Oh, hi. Fuck off. I don't think I need this anymore, but I'm going to take it with me just in case. There we go. Lit all the torches, too. Woohoo! I brought light to this dark and dank ruin place thing. So yeah, I only have two more sets. Damn. Last couple sets kind of flew by. Alright, here's the ritual.
Bringing those organs here, putting them back together. Who knows what
happened? I know what happened. Let's do it. The highest one. Now, from what I can gather from what I've read, the highest one was a member of the Dithraman clergy here, I guess we're putting it. Who betrayed Dithramon and had his organs removed, and he was basically forbidden to die. So that's kind of what this is. This is his remains, taking the form of a what are they called again? Despair demon. Yeah. Let's go ahead and attack it. Looks like those corpses got a little too close to my circle. They got sucked right in. And come on. Just die already, damn. There he goes. You can't activate that, by the way. That was the thing that summoned it.
Here's where the magic happens. Literally.
Open up. Last mosaic tile, literally the very last one. And here it is. The Secrets of Dithramin. We get Dithramin's Wisdom, which is a unique shield that only warriors can equip. Level 8, likes of it. Pretty good defense, especially with Frost. It has a 5% chance extra damage for each enemy within 8 meters. So it's a pretty cool tool to have, but not really, honestly, not really useful. Let's see what it looks like, though. It looks good, though, I have to say. Oh, that's my favorite, though. It's the same thing, just different luster. That's pretty cool. Alright, so that is that. All that's left is to kill Dragon and turn the Sylvian Blade. Woohoo! The last dragon as well. Fuck. We've come a long way. I have to say, though, I am glad that in this game they included more dragons, because in the last games, in Origins, you could only really fight, like, how many dragons? Let's see here. There was Flemeth, the Archdemon. Which way do I have to go? This way? Flemeth, Archdemon, that Spectral Dragon in, that one place. During the Awakening DLC. I know there's another dragon, but I can't remember where it was. So, oh yeah, it was outside of, gods, the place where the Veritas was, and the Awakening DLC, when you go down to find Morgan. So yeah, only like, 4 dragons. Why don't I go back to Skyhold? I'll just turn Sylvan, turn it in, that way we can end off on, the battle. So yeah, only 4 dragons in that game, technically 2 dragons in Dragon Age 2. The second dragon being an optional one in the... What's the DLC's name? Fuck. The one where we find out about Corypheus. Legacy DLC. So yeah, only fight 2 dragons in that game. This one you fight, like, what, 12? 13 if you include Corypheus' dragon? So yeah, a lot of dragons. I'm still looking forward to the next Dragon Age game, Dragon Age 4, whenever it comes out. On whatever console, whatever it's going to be about. I hope, I sincerely do, that they learned a lot from this game, especially with character customization, weapon customization, and base customization. Because the next one, I want to make my own place. I mean, go full on Minecraft for all I care. Just give me something cool. Or even Fallout 4. Fuck, I wouldn't mind that. I love the settlement building in that game. Alright, and so we got the Sylvian Blade. Let's take a look at it. So yeah, it's pretty powerful. Especially considering this is before you even put a rune on it. So imagine how powerful it becomes later on. Gives you a plus 11 on weapon penetration, 42 strength, 274 AoE, and a chance to use Pull of the Abyss on hit. And just to show it off. There it is. Like I said before, it is a very good sword, so be sure to get it. Alright, Lost Dragon. Let's just go ahead and go from over here. Makes it a lot easier. Oh boy, this dragon. Not looking forward to this. No, I'm not. Oh yeah, while I was off screen, I did go back and refight the dragon. I believe the reason why the trophy didn't pop was because I switched the trial on after the name tag popped up. You're supposed to have it on before it does. That's what I did do. Went out, fought it, killed it, got the trophy. Had a nice picture of the corpse too to delete it. I didn't really need it, so. There are very few trophy pictures I actually keep. The only ones I do keep are ones that are just perfect for whatever reason they have them. Like, I still have a picture of the trophy I got for the platinum of this game. Just because of how perfect it was. This one. Are you lagging? Yeah, a little bit, but not too bad. Oh, this way. The dragon's down in that little Colosseum area over there, and this is the strongest dragon in the game. With the exception of Krivius' dragon, and even then, that's debatable. But like I said before, this is a great place to get Silverite. You can also get a good amount of Dawnstone down here. Not Dawnstar, that's from a different game entirely. But yeah, Silverite just out the wazoo down here. Even if you don't go inside the area to fight the dragon, you can get a good amount of Silverite out here. But it's inside there that actually makes it worthwhile. Alright, let's get to it. There she is. The Highland Ravager. And she is big. Look at that. Holy fuck. I'm the size of its head. Shit. That's like the biggest dragon I've fought so far. And of course, it's elite. It is also a fire dragon, so keep that in mind. And like most dragons, it has the ability to summon little pissant children to fight against us. Plus, I know it doesn't fly away. But it does do that, of course. Luckily, I don't have to rub some Durant perk on, because that would be sucky. Come on! Oh no, what are you doing? Oh shit, it did its thing. I forgot, it has a unique ability that none of the air dragons do. That is very annoying. Similar to the shock cage that the lightning dragon can do over in the, or any lightning dragons, or if you have the effect yourself, it has a fire variant of that. Where the circle appears around you for a few seconds, and if you're able to get out of it in time, it'll cause an explosion. But you have plenty of time to be able to get out of it before it does that effect. God damn, just the wingspan of this fucking bitch. Damn, this thing's huge. I actually think it's bigger than Corypheus' dragon. Fuck. I had a lot of problems fighting her the first time. Thankfully, I've had plenty of practice since then. There it is. That's the circles I mentioned. It will cause circles to appear, then reel back and roar. That's when the that's when you know the explosion is about to happen. Again. All right, let's get close up and slash at him. Slash at her. Sorry. I was doing a shield thing again. Alright, come on. Fuck, I'm sorry, I'm still blown away by how big this dragon is. I do believe dragons do change sizes depending on their overall strength. Because I've fought in multiplayer small dragons like the one we fought last time, and then dragons of this size. So I do think that they do change size depending on their innate strength. Oh fuck. Yeah, the fire ink. Look, they haven't got out of theirs too. Normally they're stupid and stay inside of them. Come on. God damn it. Boop, fuck you. Oh, yes, come on, fall down. Damn it. What is that effect on it? Cold vulnerability. Man, if I was an ice mage. If I decided to go ice to fire, fuck. my sword's full charge. Stack! It's gonna hurt. Ow. I'm okay. I'm curious what's with the, redness just flowing off it. Makes me think you got a buff of some sort, but I can't tell. That was a nice slowdown time. Slow time. Come on, you bitch. Get out of that. Come on, come on. Fucking hell. Fall down, fall down! Nope. And here comes his children. This is the part where a lot of people actually have problems with it, because the children get in the way. Don't they always? Boop. There they are. She likes to summon her children a lot, too. Come on. Alright, she's below half. That's perfect. Alright, got rid of those two with one swoop. Perfect. Oh, getting out of that. Boop. Boop. Fuck you. God damn that fire. This is probably going to be another one-parter. Just to make up for the next set. That's going to be long. Actually, the set after that, the Trespasser DLC. Damn. Boop. Boop. Ow. Fuck off, both of you. Right, come on. I'm gonna drag to that. Yep, there I go. I'm so glad this isn't the dragon that requires the, rub some dirt on it trial. Because this bitch hits hard. If that was the case, I probably would have, switched over to Vivian. Get that resurgence perk. Maybe, I may have even just respected Lucifer to get that ability. I may, in between this set and the next one, speaking of respecking Lucifer, I may respec him. We'll see. I'll of course write down all the perks I currently have, just so I don't lose what I... Actually, I'll save before doing that. But I want to see if I can get some ice abilities, like dodging or Winter Stillness. For those that don't know what Winter Stillness does, basically it has a recharge rate for your mana increase when you're standing still. Tell
Lucifer doesn't move around a lot unless he has to, so that is a great ability to have for a mage, especially if you can get the fade step ability, which is a dodge ability, which is really fucking helpful.
I'll look into the perks that I do need, which ones I don't need, which ones I don't use, etc., etc., etc. And really work on respecking Lucifer. Get up! Alright, focus on the bitch! And here comes some more! I've heard this dragon, or the next, or the first dragon we fought here, being compared to a raid boss in an MMO. Now, I've played MMOs. I've fought raid bosses. I've played not Dragon Age, Destiny. I've played raid bosses. I've done Oryx. I haven't done any of the other ones, but I've done the Oryx raid. This is nothing like a raid. It makes you get the feeling that the person who did that claim never really played never really done a raid. He just made that assertion based off what he's heard. Or she heard, what they have heard. But what do I know? Maybe there are some MMOs that have some obscene raids that I've not even done yet. Dig it up in time. Luckily, I have obscene fire resistance, so I can stand in the fire and do nothing. Which is MMO rule number one, not do. Don't stand in fire. Come on. I wanted to kill her before she did that. Damn it. Alright. Come on. She's almost dead. Get her before she hits it. Damn it. Alright, where's Cole and Dorian? There they are. Back the fuck off, all of you! These freaking draglings, this is why I don't like draglings. Ow. Rude. Get behind you. Firebombs! Come on, you're almost dead. Here comes some more draglings, of course. Because why the hell not? You're doing your fucking circle thing again. Alright, she's almost dead. There we go. Let's get rid of these little draglings. Fuck. Don't like draglings, they're annoying. Alright, last ones. Whew. Alright, that's the last dragon. And we get Duke's Bane or Main. Nice.
Am I handsome?
God.
You say you're handsome all the time. Am I? I can't tell. You're alright. Might want to rethink the hat. But I like my hat.
Cute. Guard belt, pretty nice. Walking death, which is a dagger. Pretty good, too, by the looks of it. Masterwork, battle mage armor, and dragon bits. So, pretty good to go through them all. Now, what's cool is after you do that, this place is just filled to the brim with silverite, so be sure to get them all. You can also get Fey Touch silverite, which gives you guard plus, which is amazing. And after you finish all the dragons, you get a quest after beating Cryphius for your war table involving dragons. So it's kind of, or actually, you get a quest to get that's supposed to make it easier to kill dragons, to kill Cryphius' dragon. So it's pretty cool to have. Anyway, that's going to be it for this set. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And the next set will be the Cryphius battle. Hope you're looking forward to it, and I'll see you guys then. Till then, have a wonderful day. Bye-bye. Hello, and thank you for watching my Dragon Age Let's Play. If you'd like to see the other playthroughs, feel free to click any of the annotations below. Hope you guys have a wonderful day. Bye.